Good day to you that's watching this video. If you're subscribed to me, you're probably wondering what this video was all about. Well, it's that apple in UTAU Pitchbends, but you're probably either questioning my sanity or questioning how it's possible. So in this video, we're going to talk about how that happens. After this will be the Q&A portion, which is short. Anyway, I will be explaining how this whole thing goes now. To prepare this whole fiasco, I downloaded a video of Bad Apple, of course, and then put it through the magical box of FFmpeg and saved each frame as a PNG. I know, it sounds big, and it is. But anyway, now we got each frame of Bad Apple as a PNG. Yay! Now, before I tackle the picture to Pitchbends, I should talk about how Mode 2 Pitchbends work in the first place. A Mode 2 Pitchbend is a type of pitch deviation control that uses control points and interpolation to change the pitch of the main note over time. Sounds complicated if I explain it like that, isn't it? You should know what a pitchbend is already, I won't explain that much further. But now, let us go deeper. A Mode 2 Pitchbend is comprised of 4 parameters, PBS, PBY, PBW, and PBM. PBS probably stands for Pitchbend Start. The meanings of these acronyms are not established, but I like to think of it that way. It marks where the first control point is, with the center at the start of the note. So this first control point is 254 milliseconds away from the start of the note. Negative numbers mean going back in time, and positive means going forward. The second number also comes into play with discussing PBY, which is why it's the next parameter to discuss. PBY stands for Pitchbend Y. If you remember your Cartesian coordinates, the y-axis is the up and down direction. Only in this case, the up and down direction is the pitch, and the x-axis is the pitch of the note, like the center, like zero, I guess. One semitone down or up is equivalent to 10 units in the PBY. So negative numbers obviously means an offset down, and positive numbers means an offset up. The next parameter is now PBW. PBW is, I assume, pitch bend width. It's the best that I could come up with, at least. It shows how far the current point is from the previous point in milliseconds. Basically, it's the time between two control points. The last parameter, which I think is the most crucial part of this experiment, is PBM. PBM stands for Pitchbend Mode. It sets the four modes of the pitchbends. A blank PBM means it's all S-curves. If you see a J, it's a J-curve. If you see an R, it's an R-curve. And if you see an S, it's a... it's not an S-curve, it's a linear bend. S stands for straight in this case. A space means that it's S-curve, not when it's S. Now that that's out of the way, we're now going to break UTAU and make a bend disappear. I think there's one way that people know how to make a bend disappear, and it's to drag a bend all the way back until it's the same column as another control point. So let's do that. Ta-da! The bend disappears. If you remember PBW, it's the time between two control points. So basically, the PBW is either 0 or negative 1, because UTAU sometimes glitches and does negative 1. So obviously, from this glitch, it kind of gives a hint. And that hint is that a bend can go backwards. So, we're gonna set this one to a higher value. And now, we set it so that the pitch bend goes back in time. Though you might ask, how did you make the vertical bends then if it disappears even if it's just zero? Well, you see, there's a pitch bend mode that's an exception to disappearing, and that's the linear bend. Here's a pitch bend that has a linear bend and an S-curve bend. If I drag it to the S-curve, it disappears, but if I drag it to the linear bend, It doesn't. It also doesn't when you make the control point go back in time, so let me do that real quick. There, it doesn't disappear. Now we can look at an example of one of the frames in UTAU Pitchbends and see how it works. As you see, the PBS is way far from the start, so the pitchbends go up and up and then go back down as an S-curve so that there's gaps in between the columns. So yes, that means the pitchbend goes backwards in time. Now all that's left is to switch from S-curve to linear and to make the black and white pixels of the image. Maybe also make it so that a point is only placed when the color of the pixel doesn't change. And yes, that is how Bad Apple in UTAU Pitchbends was done. I kind of glossed over the minor fact that Bad Apple is not all black and white. It also has grays. So how did I deal with that? I dithered the image. Also, I resized the images to 144p so that the generation would be a bit faster and UTAU or AVI UTL wouldn't scream at me because of the dithering. So this is what the frames would look like in my code. Do you see the resemblance? I hope so. Now that the pitchbend explanation is done, how the heck did I put all of the 6,572 frames of Bad Apple in one video? Simple. I just used an AVR UTL plugin called UTAU. It's what I use for all of my UTAU show tuning videos. UTAU allows you to load 256 USDs, so I just did that 26 times to get videos of parts of Bad Apple, and then stitched them all right after. I still did get out of memory issues because the dithering was too powerful and made AVI UTL have a stroke. So I also have versions of the USDs with no dithering. Now that the explanation is done, we can move on to the Q&A. On to the questions.
Why?
Okay, kind of a serious answer, but do you know those videos that pretty much put the Bad Apple PV where it's not supposed to be? No? Fine. Just maybe after watching this video, look up either Bad Apple Sheep, Bad Apple MIDI Projection, Bad Apple Apple, or Bad Apple Firefox. I've always wanted to make one of those. UTAU Pitchbends gave me a chance, so I took hold of it and I started working.
How bored were you when you decided to do it? Can we know how does it sound like?
I've always had Bad Apple in UTAU Pitchbends in my mind ever since I made the help bend. I just told one of my friends about it to see if they'd want to see it. They did, so I made it.
Who's your favorite Toho girl?
I don't know, Defoco.
Is it possible to make one with the colored video?
I know two ways to do it. I'll try to explain. First one is 3-bit RGB. The three USDs would correspond to the red, green, and blue channels of the video. It would look bad because 3-bit RGB only has 8 colors. The other method is generating a palette of colors. It would be tedious though since I need a ton of USDs for it to look decent. I also need to recolor the pitchbends for each USD, so it's a no for video, but maybe for one, like, picture, it would be fine. I don't know. I don't want to try. I think that ends this Bad Apple with UTAU Pitchbends explanation and Q&A. I'll just reply to future comments if you guys still have more questions. Goodbye.